Manyan.
Professor Gauri Mahulikarji, my dear friend Dr. Spencer Wadia, friends, a very warm welcome to all of you. This is the third lecture organized by the Center for the Study of Indian Knowledge Traditions and the fourth program of this center. This initiative of the Observer Research Foundation was inaugurated by Dr. Snehlata Deshmukh, the former Vice Chancellor of Mumbai University, on the 1st of May, with a very engaging talk on health and happiness from Indian knowledge traditions. It was followed by a talk by Dr. Mayank Wahia on India's contribution to astronomy. A couple of weeks back, we organized a day-long roundtable here on the need to promote social justice, equality, harmony using India's own social reform traditions. And we were very happy to have scholars from different parts of the country and also some very dedicated social activists. It was a very fruitful roundtable. And very shortly, we'll bring out a report on the roundtable. This, friends, is the fourth program organized by the center. Dr. Gauri Mahulikar, who heads the Department of Sanskrit at Mumbai University, who is guiding our center, will tell you more about the center shortly. Dr. Spencer Wadia, an eminent physicist at TIFR, will introduce the speaker, and of course he'll also say something about the subject, being an eminent scientist himself. I must first of all thank Spencer for introducing me and introducing us at ORF to Professor Ram Subramanian. Spencer, about a couple of months back, sent me a mail saying, why don't we organize talks here, inviting two mathematicians of great repute. The first name he suggested was Professor Ram Subramanian, and the second, Dr. Manjul Bhargava, who has the distinction of being the youngest full-fledged professor of mathematics at the University of Princeton, USA, at the age of 33. Huh? Oh, sorry. 28. We are very happy to have Professor Ram Subramanian here, who accepted our invitation, and we hope that sometime in the future we'll also have Dr. Manjul Bhargava. I was very keen to know something about Dr. Manjul Bhargava, and I found this interesting bit on the net. I'll read out to you, friends. At 28, Manjul Bhargava has already won a coveted full professorship at the Department of Mathematics, Princeton University. An expert in number theory, the study of properties and relationships of numbers, Bhargava is also a master of the tabla, a small Indian hand drum used to create music with rhythmic, precise patterns. Number theory is a type of math that describes a swirl in the head of a sunflower and the curve of a chambered nautilus. Bhargava says, It's also hidden. The number theory is hidden in the rhythms of classical Indian music, which is both mathematical and improvisational. He sees close links between his two loves. Both create beauty and elegance by weaving together seemingly unconnected ideas. Just goes to show that this new crop of mathematicians are not only making great contribution to the field of mathematics, but also discovering and disseminating the interconnectedness of mathematics to knowledge as a whole, to seemingly unconnected domains like music, and to life in general. It is said that mathematics is the language of the universe. God created universe by following the very strict architecture dictated by mathematics. It permeates everything. And for all of us, it's a matter of pride that India has made immense contribution to the growth of mathematics. And we'll very shortly hear from Professor Ram Subramanian what that contribution has been. I'll close my remarks, friends, by just making one comment. While all of you were waiting for the function to start, sipping tea and just getting introduced to each other, I asked a regular visitor to our programs what he thought of the activities at ORF. He said, "I like them very much, especially because you try to bring in the moral angle, the ethical angle in almost every subject that you deal with here. I don't know how much we actually do it, but I take this comment as a direction, as a suggestion for what we should be doing as a think tank. A think tank, friends, is not just to discuss issues in an academic manner. It is to attempt to go to the core of every issue, and the core is morals and ethics. So I was asking myself whether there is any connection between mathematics and morals. All I can say is that if mathematics is about the search for truth, then it is also about morality. Because at the very core, truth and morality are inseparable. Although in the field of mathematics, it may seem totally abstract. As our traditions tell us, truth and mathematics is beautiful. Truth, beauty and divinity are inseparable. Satyam, Shivam, Sundaram. So if mathematics is beautiful, and most anybody who has studied mathematics with any passion and with a little bit of interest knows how beautiful it is. And therefore, friends, I think that there is also a moral angle to the study of mathematics. And I'm not an expert, but my belief is that our ancient rishis and scientists who contributed to the growth of mathematics were not just studying mathematics, they were studying life, they were studying nature, they were studying cosmos in all its totality. And I'm very happy that in Professor Ram Subramanian we have a scholar, a mathematician, who takes a view of mathematics that is beyond mathematics, and I hope it will be apparent in his talk. Thank you very much. And I now request Dr. Gauri Mahulikar to tell you briefly about the Center for the Study of Indian Knowledge Tradition.